Doamne, ține. Aleluia. Amen. Yes. I want to thank God for this moment. I know God has been with us from the moment to this point. And tonight I'm not doing too much of a preaching, but it's just a little bit of a presentation. Hallelujah. I know we all know about faith. But before I read some few scriptures, I want to tell you about a story. I don't know, we all know about the story. It's about the story of David. Hallelujah. When David was in the wilderness taking care of the sheep, when the bear and the lion came, right? Some of us will ask, Lord, if you love David, why should you allow in the first place for the lion to attack the sheep? But God was doing something, hallelujah. The reason why God was doing that was he was preparing the history, hallelujah. So David had the first testimony. And when the first testimony came, the second man came. He overpowered the second one, and now David was so strong. And what happened? When David was asked to send food to his brethren, the war failed. And when David got there, something happened. Hallelujah. Goliath was there trying to defy the armies of the living God. But when David got there, because of the testimony, hallelujah, because of the faith he had in the word, David said, no way, I will not allow this or else circumcise to defy the armies of the living God. Hallelujah. So here, in our daily lives, we encounter problems, worries, attack from here and there. By all this, God is preparing us, hallelujah. God is preparing us, hallelujah. God is giving us the faith in order to overcome higher troubles. Right. And now when David appeared before Saul, Saul said, who are you? You are just but a youth. You are just but a youth, you can't do anything. Today's small words, you can't preach. Today's small words, you can't do anything. But David said, okay, so listen to my testimony. In the wilderness, the bear came, I overcame the bear. The lion came and I killed the lion. This man, I'm doing the same thing to you. Hallelujah. And Saul, being a man of God before, because at that stage he was falling. But being a man of God before, he knows the word. So when David spoke the word, he said, go, the Lord will be with you. Hallelujah. And then he went and he slew Goliath. So whatever we go through today, we should count it all to a hallelujah. No matter what the problem, if it's our business, it's our business. All the time, we proclaim we have faith. We have faith. We have faith. But faith doesn't work alone. Faith always works with belief. They will tell you, we believe we have faith. But when the issue comes, then you know they don't believe. When the issue comes, you know sometimes you don't have faith. Because faith always works with belief. So you first have to what? Believe. The Bible said, Abraham believed the word of God. Hallelujah. And the word of God extends the troubles, right? From the days of Abraham to the days of the apostles to our day. And our day, what voice? That's what we're saying. What voice? God has sent forth his voice again. And what we have to do is believe. When we believe, the Bible said to us, because he said to Abraham, it was accounted to him for righteousness. To us, the Bible said the same thing. If we also believe, it will also account to us as what? Righteousness. So let us believe. Hallelujah. Let us believe. When it comes to the message of the hour, people want to split the message into two. Hallelujah. And they want to stand on only one side. But we want to believe the word in its entirety. Hallelujah. If we believe everything, because everything about Abraham believed everything. And it goes to a point, the Bible said, it's not even by words. But Abraham believed. Hallelujah. So if you claim you have faith and you don't believe in the first place, the faith is not there. The faith is not there because you don't believe. But we always claim we have faith. We have faith. We have faith. But when the real issue comes, they put the Bible aside and they do it the way of man. Hallelujah. But we want to stand on the word. We want to believe everything. And our faith, Bible said, it will be counted to us as righteousness. I want us to project one day. This Bible talks something about faith. I want us to read it. And this is from the super sense. And the super sense is the Holy Spirit, the feet of God. that dwells in you, and if you will let the five senses be yielded to the sixth sense, it will guide you and bring all the other five senses under control of that super sense, for it is so far above the natural senses as the spiritual man is above the natural.
Amen.
It is as far as high as the heavens is above the natural man and his five senses. It makes you believe things that you cannot see. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is faith. It makes you believe things that you cannot see.
Amen.
It makes you act where you do not think five senses will ever think about it. The devil can get into these five senses and lie to you, but he cannot touch that super sense. Hallelujah. That's far beyond his reach. That comes from God. It is called faith. Faith is that great. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we come to these five senses, sometimes if it doesn't take time, it will kill your faith. Hallelujah. It will kill your faith because sometimes you'll be praying for. You believe you are healed. And on the way going, you start feeling the pain. The five senses will tell you, oh, what you said, you are healed. But the pain is there. Hallelujah. You pray for your job and you say it is well. And you face two challenges. The five senses will tell you. But you said everything is well. But look at the problems you are going through. The five senses, if you don't take time, to kill your faith. But Abraham said, the sixth one, which is the faith of God, the super sense, that is what we need. Hallelujah. That's the faith we need. Hallelujah. If you have that faith, he said, the devil cannot reach that one. Hallelujah. The devil cannot reach out, and that is the kind of faith you are looking for. Hallelujah. The kind of faith you are looking for. And that faith will never allow you to disbelieve the word of God. You will not. Hallelujah. You will not. Because he said it's the faith of God. And if you have that one, you will never disbelieve the word of God. And there is this testimony. There was a testimony. Yes, there is this testimony. I believe we all know about this testimony about one old John Ryan. I don't want to read the whole thing, it's too long, but I just want to summarize it. His five senses nearly played into his healing. Brother said he prayed for this man. The man was a Catholic. He prayed for him. And another time he realized the man is in the queue again. And he said, well, I pray for you. Do you believe? He said, I believe. He said, if you believe, why are you here? To that point, but the five senses were trying to blame him. He believes he is healed, but the next day, prayer line, he was there again. Because what's going on? And I said, you go, believe. If you believe me, go. Hallelujah. And keep on praising God. And I said, now this man was everywhere praising God. Even when he comes to church, he said, praise God, I am healed. Praise God, I am healed. In the marketplace, praise God, I am healed. And he got to a point, people want to make fun of him. They do it to us today. They want to make fun of you. Hallelujah. And if you don't take time, the five senses will come in. Let us make sure we put the five senses away. Hallelujah. Let us put them away. And stay with the sixth one, the super sense. And the Bible asks him, because he went to the barber shop, and he said, now he wants to make fun of him. We let that you meet to that prophet, he has prayed for you, and he said, yeah. He said, yeah, I'm healed. And immediately, what happened? His eye opened. And he shouted from his seat. He ran to the street. I am healed. I am healed. I am healed. Hallelujah. So we've got to hold on to that faith. We've got to hold on to it in spite of whatever happened to us. Hallelujah. The Bible said, as Abraham believed, it was counted to him as righteousness. Same to us. Hallelujah. And if it is so, then all the fourfold blessings that God gave to Abraham, he will give it to you. Hallelujah. And it's what the spiritual blessings, the physical blessing, the financial blessing, and the material blessing. Hallelujah. But today, sometimes, we look at blessing in the direction of money. We only look at blessing in the direction of money. And when you don't have money, over the day, oh, you are not blessed. Oh, you, this man is a Christian, he has prayed and prayed. Look at his life. No! Blessing is not about money. Hallelujah. It is one full blessing. And the most important thing is the spiritual one. That is what God always gives to us. And I'll prove that. Lazarus and the rich man. Hallelujah.
Is it Lazarus?
Lazarus and the rich man. The spiritually, Lazarus was okay. That is a spiritual blessing. The first one. Physical blessing, he was poor because he was sick at that time. Saul all over him. Financial blessing, he was poor. Materially, he was poor. But God always won the first one. Hallelujah. And what happened? He died and he landed in the bosom of Abraham. The rich man, with his money, the whole world thought, this is the blessed man. When he died, when did he land there? Hallelujah. So money is good, but it's not a sign of blessing. Hallelujah. It's not a sign of blessing. It's part of the blessing. But God will always make sure that our spiritual one comes first.
Amen.
That's why he said, seek ye first the kingdom of God. That is the spiritual one. When you get that one, the physical one will come. Hallelujah. So if you are going through hard time today, doesn't mean God is not blessing you. You are blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody told me a testimony this morning and he said, he had a friend, and the friend has got money. And he had a little baby, about 11 months old. And it is today sickness, tomorrow sickness, and he has spent everything. And just a few days, the little boy died. And when he died, he said, when he heard it, he stood back and said, God, they are blessed. Because look at my children. They go about every day. And nothing of that sort has happened to them. It is a blessing. So I told him, these are some of the blessings God will always bless us with.
Hallelujah.
So money, he will bless you. Hallelujah. Physically, he will bless you. Spiritually, physically, he will bless you. He will bless you. So if you are going through any of this, do not be afraid. Hallelujah. For you know your maker, Lord, is always with you. Hallelujah. And so we will just raise this almost 20 to 8 o'clock. Continue to pray. Hallelujah. Just a little bit of presentation. Amen.
Amen.
I hope your faith is changing up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hope your faith is up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because we are in the days of blessings. We are in the days of miracle. Because the miracle God blessed Brahman's message. The same miracle is here. Because Bible said he is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Hallelujah. Amen.
So what he did in those days, he will do it today. Hallelujah. The blessings we read, we always read in the Bible, he's still doing it today.
Hallelujah.
We just have to prepare our faith, position ourselves in the right place to receive. Hallelujah. The Lord is a giving God. Hallelujah. So we use this the rest of the time to pray. Hallelujah. Let us be on our feet. God can do anything. Make sure you pray for it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If your friend is sick, don't be afraid to pray. You are not a healer. God is a healer.
Hallelujah.
And God will do it. In the name of Jesus. Because God is a great healer. But do you know our challenge is fear? Sometimes when you look at the situation or the problem, you ask yourself, what about if I pray for it and nothing happened?
Amen.
They will say, I'm a false preacher. I'm a false pastor. No! No! Let me tell you this one. There was an end time message pastor, I think he was from Cameroon. He went to France. He ministered there and he went to the restaurant with the French pastor. And whilst sitting down, there was this man coming in to eat, and the man had a problem with the leg. One is shorter than the other. So when the man was coming, the pastor fell here to pray for me. But quickly, fear gripped him. He said, this one, what about if I pray for him and he doesn't come? What will I do? But quickly, he said, he heard another voice. He said, you are not the healer. I am the healer. Just pray and live it. If it doesn't happen, it is me, God. You know, sometimes we want to take the glory of God. Therefore, we are afraid. But if you don't want to take the glory of God, just pray anyhow. God will do it. It's like faith. Hallelujah. And the man did one thing. He went to that man. He said, I want to pray for you. Immediately the man said, You know how many pastors have prayed for me? And the thing is still there. He even crippled the pastor the more. The pastor said, I think that you pray for me. Do you believe? He said, I believe. I always go to pastors to pray for me. The pastor prayed with him. Hallelujah. Amen. And the story ended there. This man traveled back to Cameroon. I think about 2 or 3 weeks, he had a phone call from France. And the pastor, the France pastor was shouting, praise God, praise God. And God has said, he said, the man you pray for, he is healed. He is walking. The man said his face shoot up like that. Hallelujah. So it is not about you, it is about God. Hallelujah. So just add the word, speak the word, and let God do it. So if there is any blind man you feel led to pray for, pray. It is not you. If anyone comes in our base, heal, sick, pray them. If you know somebody struggling, pray them.
Amen.
It is not us, it is God.
Amen.
The word has proven it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The word has proven it. And so Peter's shadow can be healed.
Amen.
So the word is still here today.
Amen.
The word is not there. Hallelujah. The word is still here. Hallelujah. Now faith is out. I want you to do one thing. Speak to your problem. Command it. Hallelujah. Don't negotiate. Hallelujah. Just speak to it by faith. God will honor his word. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, your word has come to us tonight. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus. Lord, by faith, I speak to end the problem. I pray that you will take total control. Lord, I take total control of every situation. In this coming block, in the deliverance, Lord. I want you to declare, if any of your family member, you feel that God should bring that person to Christ. Any friend you know, and you wish like he will also serve God like you, I want you to declare. Talk to God and say, God, it's my heart desire that all my family members will believe this message. Hallelujah. Talk to God and say, God, it's my heart desire that all my friends will come to believe. bring this message, let us pray. Father, I declare and I decree right now in the name of Jesus that Lord, my family of God will come and those who will come and believe this message of the hour. Lord, I declare and I decree, Lord, that all my friends that I know, Lord Jesus, will come and believe this message in the name of Jesus, because it's the message of the hour, the message of the day. Lord, I pray in the holy name of Jesus, Almighty Father, that Lord, you speak to my friend, speak to my family, wherever they are, we pray, Lord, bring them, Lord, to your presence, to come and be your word, to come serve you, to come be one with us. Lord, I pray for my family, I pray for my mother, I pray for my father, I pray for all my siblings, oh God. Lord, it's my prayer that those who do know you, Lord, will come to those you, Lord, that are fellowship around your word. All of our friends, we pray, Jesus. We pray, Lord. We pray, Lord. Oh, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I want us to pray that God will add to us. Hallelujah. God has started something good here, hallelujah. And if you can open up, you can feel it, you can smell it. God is doing great things in our midst. And I want us to pray. Add to us, Lord. Wherever we find ourselves, let our characters win souls for you. Hallelujah. Let us pray for so many. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray that Lord, you will add to us, Lord. Something good with us. We want to all your children to come and enjoy it, Lord. Therefore, we pray that let our lives go witness to people. Let our lives witness to people. Let our lives witness to people. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let our lives of God be a witnessing tool to bring people to your kingdom. Because that which of God should have on them, that will be lost. Don't be very people here. Very people, Jesus. Hallelujah. I am a fan of love so much because I know what love can do. At a point, even Brahma who have shown love and mad cow and power. He said he was on his way to pray for somebody and there was this mad cow going this way and that has already killed some few people on the way. And when he met that cow, he stood there. He said, I'm sorry, I come across your path. I'm going to pray for someone. I'm not here to hurt you. He said he was moved with love. Hallelujah. And then Mark Havana. So I want us to pray that God will fill us with love. Love to love one another. Love to think positive. Oh, love for the church. Because if you start with love, you grow with love. Let us pray that the love of God will be in us. I will pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord, we pray for love. Lord, we pray for love. Grant us love in the name of Jesus. Grant us love in the name of Jesus. Father, because love is a great tool. But so without love, no one can see God. I pray that you give us love. Love to love each other. Love to love one another. Love that will walk us up to take negative against each other. But love to bring us together. We will love. Lord, we pray for love, we pray for love, we pray for love, we pray for love in the holy name of Jesus. Oh, yes, we thank you. We bless your name in the holy name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you in the name of Jesus. You are
know we are all one people. Without you, we can't do anything. That is the foundation of this church. But we need your presence.
Yeah.
We need your approach every time we
pray.
Not be able to take anybody by ourselves.
Oh.
But give all the glory.
Yeah.
We say we thank you.
Yes.
For humble our hearts.
Yes.
Humble our ways.
Yes.
Humble our approach to our time, like you said. Jesus, that's the love of all that we're going to work on. May we put an atmosphere to work on you.
yesterday, today, and tomorrow, there's no difference. Jesus is the same. Amen. As you go with that heart of assurance. Yeah.